try and find it. I found it. And, good. And we need to set that one on. And now we need that one and that one. And we need that one and that one. Whoa, we're there. Look at that. We're in business. We need a 66. Just that one. Good afternoon, driver. Today we'll be shunting cargo to the correct destination. In the sidings you have some coal wagons, container cars, tankers and wood transporters. It is your job to get them to the correct destination. First off, we'll couple the coal wagons to the front of the 66 and push them to coal yard 2. Looks good if you have to couple the cargo to the back or the front of the engine if you are currently facing with the coal wagons. Right. Let's see what the instructions say. Couple that lot to the front. Is that the front? It is. Right. Brakes are coming off. Let me put it on digital throttle. Maybe it'll work now. Yep. So we're going to uncouple to these wagons as instructed. BNSF, for your scenario, I'm doing version 2. Right. We've coupled. What's next? We are going to coal yard 2. Are we pushing these? We're pushing these wagons all around. Oh dear, oh dear. Bad form. Right, so we're going to push these wagons all the way up there. I can't believe we're pushing these wagons, darkness monster. No, I'm not missing anything. We are actually going to push them. Alright, and we're off. This is indeed Hedborough North, BNSF. What number? 66584. Gentle as we're pushing these rounds. Last thing we want us to do is knock them off. That would just, you know, be what happens. Alright, we're going round. BNSF, a tunnel decal will not block scenery, so you can put scenery anywhere you like. A tunnel decal will not block scenery. But similarly, you can't use a tunnel decal to cut holes in scenery either. Tunnel decal just gets rid of the terrain. How are we doing? Let's get up the other side. Hey, Deadly Jurito. Thanks for joining this evening. And that was an epic goodnight message with all those names on it. Wagon Simulator. Got all these wagons hauling a 66. It's nice to use Hedborough North again, actually. It's a nice little shunting route. Alright, we're on our way around and we're going to stop at there. We're going to drop those off in there, and then we're going to couple those ones to the back, so we're going to come round and get those. And then we're going to bring those into here and then run round, presumably. Okay. Alright, I assume we've got a reasonable plan of what we're doing. A yin yin, if you don't mind. Yes, a yin yin. Nice one, Cameron's Gaming. Right, we're coming into Coal Yard 2, which is our correct destination. Speed up a bit, we're never going to get there. I missed a couple of follows actually. Nick's Games, Nick's Game, TIJD, Huffer Mouse, Power Slave. Thank you for the follows, folks. Right, now we're coming in. Yard. We just stop first. Must remember, it's not just uncouple, it's stop first. Reversing up nicely. Francois, this route, Hedborough North, is available on Steam Workshop, as are the three routes that were, the fictional routes were all put up on Steam Workshop. I know, because I put them on Steam Workshop. Right. Drop off those next, and then we're going to head back to siding 2, which is a change over to there. So as soon as it gives me the all clear, I can uncouple. Right, head over to siding 2 and get the container wagons. Green light, so we're good to go. Right, 25 limit now. So, Estrice Francois, the Seaburg Barn, Hedborough North, and Castle Rock are fictional routes that are based on real routes. So this route, I can't remember where it's based, but it is actually based on a real route. And Seaburg Barn is based on Interlaken. I can't remember where Castle Rock is. But they are based on real world routes. They're just not real world routes, so they don't have the right scenery necessarily. Have I done an SD75 scenario for the stream? I can't remember. Francois has a database, a spreadsheet, which lists all of the scenarios that I've done and all the locos I've done. So that'll be able to tell you if I've done it and how many times I've done it. Immingham Docks, there it is. Yes, Sarge, okay, you're right. Oh, well, I've got them around the wrong way. There you go. I've got it around the right way now. Apologies. BNSF, if Francois can send a link, I think the... Have I got the latest one linked, Francois, on the profile, or do you need to? Do you want to just post the link? Oh, it's gone green. Yeah, I shall get the videos all up to date this weekend. I've been really busy this week, so I haven't had a chance to do anything. Sadly, that's today's excuse at any rate. Yeah, to be honest, there's not much I haven't done. Stephen Jam, I think we've had transcoding for a good while now. Dragon, please do post it. You'll need to get one of the moderators to just give you a grant to make... Oh no, actually, Steam Workshop should just work. So yes, please do. Right, we've almost got these wagons. Coming up to siding 2 now. That tea won't drink itself. That tea was gone a long time ago. Right. Let's go and get these container wagons. Right, nearly there. Punch. Right, now we're off to container yard 3. Let's make sure that the junctions are all set correctly. Oh look, they're not. And we might as well make sure we're clear all the way through to the head shunt there. Right, we are. Oh, we've even got the headlights set the correct way. Heading back forwards again. The 2000s? What do you mean Tyson is called the 2000s? Do you mean the year? I like all the years. Wish we're on the correct side of the wagons this time. I don't feel so bad. Just get in the cab for a little while. Good job. I was told to tab, so I have tabbed. Said, first gear Simmons. Have you turned your engine off? Keep your feet off the desk. Yeah, definitely keep your feet off the desk. Right, let's get sped up to 25. Back in the cab, we've got another alarm. Danger approved. That's changing direction. I thought that would put a 15 point. Maybe I'm just being fussy. Oh, Francois has changed the link to his spreadsheet so that anyone can comment. So if there's anything you think is wrong or any ideas you've got, then you can add that into his spreadsheet. Which is an excellent idea. Good night, Scravesnet. Right, so we're coming into container yard 3, where we will be stopping, dropping, and moving to container shunt 2. Apparently, I haven't done an SD-75. Oh, well, there you go then, BNSF. That's the that can be the subject of your next scenario. Right, coming into container yard 3, we can drop the wagons off in here. We've got to do a stop and then a drop. Bam, is this my route? No, this is not my route. I published it onto Steam Workshop, but it's certainly not my route. It's one of the three fictional routes that was added in Railworks 3 TS 2012. And then in 2013 they were taken out. Because they're still perfectly good, perfectly enjoyable routes, they were made available on Steam Workshop. Right, so we've got to drop these off, then we're going to move into container shunt 2, run around the wagons and come and get those wagons. My word, that's a lot of shunting we've got to do. Right, drop off. Take a quick stop at container shunt 2, set the switches to go back, pick up the wood train at siding 4. Once you've picked those up, you can push them to wood yard 3. On the instructions to tell me what to do later on. How was I able to publish the three routes? Well, I was asked to. I had permission to. They're all published on my work account, so it was really just a question of someone needs to put them on Workshop. Cheers, First Gear Sims. Thanks for joining this evening. Didn't they require special assets? No. These routes required nothing but the European assets. So they were able to be published. Right. Get into the container shunt. First Gear Sims, yeah, please do. Yeah, drop me an email. No problem at all. Make sure I'm clear of that point. I am. PC Fantastic, when did you send me a message? So we're going to run round, clear that one, and this time we're going into this siding here. So I'm going to have to come in here, back here, and then come round here. Okay, we're ready to go. We are. Little brainwave piece of fantastic. Okay, go on. got double white, so we're good to carry on. We'll get 25 permission in a moment, and we can carry on. Oh, the Google Docs form. Yes, yeah. That's already done. You mean for submitting scenarios, that's how it's done now. Works very well. Right, we're on our way back to get these wagons. Signal. Excellent. How do I do the new way of submitting scenarios? It's done via Google Docs form. There you go, there's a link to the Google Docs form. So you can, if you fill that form in, it gets added into the list. Mac for Minecraft? I'm going to try and have a look this weekend, actually. I haven't had a chance so far. As I said, this week I've been incredibly busy at work. But I'm going to try and chill out a bit this weekend. Monty the horse can't sleep, so he's back. Welcome back. Oh, AWS, I hate you. Right. Oh, I've used modded Minecraft before, Mac for Minecraft. My kids have had just about every mod under the sun installed on their own systems at one time or another. At one point, my daughter was requesting a new mod to be installed on Minecraft, I think, twice a day. In this case, why don't you play with the ones you've got for 5 minutes? Never mind. That was where we played with Traincraft the first time. Because I installed that one for Cameron on his machine. This is before we had a server. Cheers, PC Fantask. Moggy uses his don't install Minecraft mod. Need to go that way and then reverse back up into these ones. Right. Landing lights and nav lights, Briggsy. Yeah, that wouldn't be too bad, would it? Right, making our way around here. Now we are coupling to the back, aren't we? Yes, we are. Right, change that junction, change that junction. That gets us into the right line, and then we're going to push those to Woodyard 3. So, that'll get us out. And then we can push it to Woodyard 3. Good. Gouger, does if you have two assets that use the same texture, does it get loaded twice? No, I don't think it does. So you ideally want to do as little as... use as few textures as possible and spread them across as many assets as possible. I think that's the best way of doing it. I reserve the right to be entirely wrong, but that is my understanding. Have I taken the handbrake off? Yep, handbrake's off. No, Moggy, I haven't seen the official FSX stream yet. I haven't done anything really recently, I've been so busy. Let's push. To do is keep an eye out on the points. Let's go a bit slower around the corner here. Right, so that's going to cross us over into here, and we need to go into the middle road there. Good. A little way till we get there yet, though. Hey, Sunset Limited, welcome. Glasgow to Largs. Is that not part of the Glasgow Carlisle route? I know it covers quite a lot around in the area around Glasgow. But I don't know particularly well which exactly it does. Right, so this is going to take us, so we're actually on to the main line over here at the moment. And we'll run round past here and up into the woodyard. Shouldn't take us too long to get there. We're going to get a limit increase in a minute, but... Sunset Limited, have you raised a support ticket with Dovetail? to find out if there's any answers to those questions. Because certainly everything shouldn't be invisible. It should be working fine in that respect. So, if you're having a problem, fire an email or fire a ticket off to the support system. These wagons, I don't remember where these wagons come from, if I'm honest, BNSF. We're going straight on. Yes, Kev, this is a rather long propelling movement, but never mind. There you go, Darkness wants to know. It's the OTA wagon pack. Right, come around the corner. We're going to be crossing over the junction here. Need to be checking the light as we come around the corner. So we've got green at the moment. Mac for Minecraft. I'm not in charge of what routes we make, so it's DTG Steve you need to be doing, or just go write an article on Engine Driver and get it into the public eye. Doesn't guarantee a route will be made, but it gets it there to where people can see it, and you can explain exactly why you think that's a good route. JM, Bloodban is coming when you least expect it, sir. Least expected. Right. If you make some scenarios for some holidays, think you can play the scenario in that holiday? I don't see why not. Sounds an interesting idea. Throttle off, let the wagons coast over the point. How are we doing now? Coming around the corner here, and the blue line is set to take us into the right place. Superb! Cameron's Gaming? I've got no idea. 0.7 tons of coal. That seems like it'd be quite light, to be honest. Thank you. Sorry, hold you up. Right, we've got a 10 limit as we come into Woodyard. Mad Drop Bear, go and find Mesh Tools on Facebook and go and have a look through their previous posts. You might be pleasantly surprised. Mac for Minecraft, name MMO mode. I'm really torn by that sort of thing, because I think it would be kind of cool to have that kind of gameplay. I like that gameplay in games like Elite and Euro Truck. But it's entirely not how the real world works, so when you're that would be really would be gamification of the game, and something that a lot of people just don't want the game to do. Okay, we're in. What's next? Drop off those and then go back to siding 5 and couple to the front. Those to the front and head back to Pretoria, so we'll be pulling those. Okay, basically got two more moves to do then. Right, head back to siding 5. Did just catch the mute button just in time. Yay me. Right, let's roll back here. Is it possible for Dubtile to waste 210 models with 8 locos and 40 pieces of rolling stock? Of course. It would be an expensive route. Let's try the microphone now, is that better? Good night, Strat Shadow. Ooh, thank you. Looking forward to that on Sunday. Right, get another AWS alarm in a moment. Bam, if you're talking about publishing something as a third party, then I would definitely talk to a third party team and get their advice on that. Is it technically possible? Of course it is. It's down to you what you want to make. Mac for Minecraft DLC costs are nothing to do with me, I'm afraid. Red light there to tab through in a moment. Coming up on siding 5 where we need to couple up to our first batch of wagons, freight cars. Right, we are approved through to tab. We've done that. Oh, okay, we've got green light, we're good to go. There are no cabooses. Right, let's get these two loads of or cuts of wagons. You haven't been taking many screenshots, have I, Douglas? I'll take a screenshot in a minute. Planning on buying a HoloLens. I'm going to definitely wait and see what people feel, see what people think of it when they have it, the cold hard actual thing in its hand. I'm really excited by HoloLens, but also very wary of it. Right, now we need to go to siding 6, and again it's coupled to the front, so we've got to go back and then come in again. HoloLens, I can't remember what the release date for HoloLens is, but it's not too far off. They said it would be in the same time frame as Windows 10. Glad to keep up with extremes to YouTube. Absolutely, Francois. I just, like I said, I've been way too busy this week to do anything. This weekend, we'll try and get probably 20 or so videos uploaded from this week. I only stream Monday, Tuesday, plus today, so Wednesday, Thursday, there wasn't actually a stream, but still. Right, cleared the red light. The goal actually is to stop here, please. Thank you. Are we clear? I don't know. I think I need to go a little bit more. I do. Oops. Gotta get past this point so that we can change it. Now bound for siding 6. Some more tankers to pick up. Where are we going with these anyway? Petroleum yard. Oh, it's just round there. Okay. Mac for Minecraft? Yes, I've used Railcam before. It's very good. Friday of last week wasn't uploaded either. Ah, did I do a stream last Friday? In that case, I'm further behind than I thought I was. Oopsie. Right, now we're off to the petroleum yard. Have I played Trains New Era? Yes, I have, Mac for Minecraft. I've played every train simulator. Alright, clear through that red light. Would I be doing any train spotting videos or speedrun? Yes, I'm certainly going to be doing more train spotting videos, absolutely. A speedrun from London to Brighton, that would actually be quite interesting. Okay, so we are going to Petroleum Yard 4, which we are cleared into. What about the line at the end? We are not. That gets us into... Yard 4, go to there, back to depot shunt, and into the refueling point. Oh, this is the last move then, the last move of wagons, and anyway. What is that place you're driving in? This is Hedborough North for our fan game. Right, so, carrying on around the corner here, we're heading for the petroleum siding, which is just over a mile away. 25 limit. We should probably obey the 25 limit. Right, I think the petroleum siding's just up here. Right. There we go, Petroleum Yard 4 has just arrived. So we'll drop these wagons off here, do a stop and drop, and then we can run round and go and drop the wagon and the refuelling siding. Fifteen limit as we come into the Petroleum Yard. Get the brake gauge that the 66 has got and put it onto one of these panels so that I don't have to keep going to the cab to see what the brakes are doing. Siding now. Oh, this is going to be a snug fit. Right, we'll stop and drop. So we're going to stop, drop, move forward into Petroleum 3, and then head back round to Depot Shunt, and then reverse in and come into this refuelling point. Right, let's do the uncouple. Well done, you can exit the Petroleum Yard via Petroleum Shunt 3, and after that part the engine at refuelling point. Where I find out I can't actually get out the other side. I can. Good. change that point, and then that point, and that point. That gets us to depot shunt. Cheers, Tyrone One. Glad you enjoyed the stream and have a great weekend. Bam. Make sure every scenario you do is less than 60 minutes. As much as people like, some people, very few people, like the long ones, majority of people will never finish anything longer than 60 minutes. There's just no point in creating a scenario people aren't going to do. Ralph Fangame, should you play TS 2016 now and keep the stream on another computer? That sounds like an interesting idea. A lot of people do that, actually. V. Brucey, evening. Welcome. Like I said, Moggy, Bam, talk to the partner team and they'll be able to tell you all sorts of guidelines that will help you make an add-on that the majority of people will enjoy. You can always take your long scenarios and put them on Steam Workshop, for example. You don't have to include them in the pack. So, you know, there's solutions to these things. Right, we're just going to put the loco into the refueling siding now. A bag of skips? Ooh, Moggy. Settle down, settle down. Such crazy behaviour at this time of the day. Just saw it and I missed it. V. Brucey, this route is on Steam Workshop. It's called Hedborough North. There's the sea depot over there. Right, we've approved to pass the red. We're crossing over here onto the other side. Right. So we're now cleared to come into here and up to here. We're going to main shed 1 and then back up to the refueling point. Is it refueling point 2 we're going to? Nope, it's refueling point 1 we're going to. Which means I need to change these points. Right, that's it. In which case, once it tells us we can go, we've got the weights that tells us we're going in the yard. That's it. Cameron's Gaming branching off. Yes, it went very well. Very well indeed, actually. I thoroughly enjoyed it. Right. It's got 5 mph limit as we come into here. Definition of agony. Right, we're coming into the refueling siding now. And that's it. Another scenario bites the dust. I'm going to take a copy of that map, because that's pretty interesting. Right. Well done. Now it's time for some rest, head in and grab some coffee. Superb. Right, that was Sorting the Goods by Darkness Monster. Thank you, Darkness Monster! Right, one more scenario to go, and this one's not a long one, folks. This is not a long one. Right, veterans on the coast. Let's go and do that one. This is by BNSF 2001. Mac for Minecraft. I've got all of the add-ons.